As you've seen in the last video of the previous module, we've decided to set up a WordPress.org site. This means you're going to have to get hosting and a domain name. Now, the tricky thing with this topic is that the way you get WordPress up and running depends on the way your hosting company has set this up. Ideally, we would like to show you a one-size-fits-all tutorial video, but in this case, that's just not possible. To give you a general idea of the process, we'll use one hosting company as an example case in the upcoming screencasts. In this video, we'll discuss a number of things you should consider when going through the process of selecting hosting and a domain name and installing WordPress. First of all, you'll have to decide what hosting company and what plan suits your needs. We believe that investing in good hosting is always the way to go. You don't want to share servers with lots of other websites, for example, because that slows down your site. Saving a few bucks on hosting just isn't worth it in the end. In the reading materials, we'll go into everything you should consider when picking a host in more detail. Then there's the issue of picking your domain name. Domain names are a very important part of building a brand and thus require some thinking. You want people to be able to recognize you and find you if they're looking for you. That's why it's often a good idea to have a short domain name that is easy to type. And if it's catchy, that helps as well, of course. Take our example site domain, everydayimtraveling.com. To be honest, it's not the first domain name I would choose, because it's quite difficult. Still, it is catchy and it has a ring to it. So I still like it as an example site, but ideally, you'd like a shorter domain name that's easier to spell. If you have a company, you'll probably want your company name as a domain name. It's also very important to consider what TLD you choose. A TLD is the last bit of your homepage URL, so for example .com or .gov or .org. Of course, .com is the most recognizable TLD, and if you're going to operate internationally, it's really the only way to go. But good luck trying to find a good .com domain name that isn't already taken. That's one of the reasons we went for everydayimtraveling.com, actually. If your audience exclusively consists of people within a specific country, you could pick a CC TLD as well, like .nl for the Netherlands. We'll go into TLDs a bit more in the reading materials. So, let's say you've picked a host and a domain name you like. What does the process usually look like after that? Well, there's different ways to go about this. For one, it's often cheaper to register a domain name and hosting separately. There are numerous sites that allow you to register a domain name, but look out, prices vary a lot. So make sure you do proper research and compare prices. If you don't think a couple of bucks are worth the hassle, you can get your domain name and hosting all at once as well. Now, when you get hosting, it really helps to check whether your hosting company makes it easy for you to set up WordPress. Again, we'll review some of the choices you have to make when selecting a host in more detail in the reading materials. Most dedicated WordPress hosting parties make it very easy for you to set up WordPress. You simply visit their site, pick a plan, follow the instructions, and poof, you have a working WordPress installation. We've listed some suitable hosts that make installing WordPress easy for you in the reading materials. Now, once you've selected a plan, most hosts will ask you to choose a domain or fill in the domain you already have. Then it's just a matter of filling in your details and you've got your domain and hosting covered. Which leaves setting up your site. As I've said before, this really depends on how the hosting company has set this up, but let's just focus on a few things you should definitely pay attention to. What's very important is that you set up your admin account properly. Never use admin as the username. Pick your own custom username and pick a strong password, preferably one that you save in a password manager. Secondly, let's talk security. Always make sure your website is on HTTPS. Now, we're not going to go into the details too much because it gets technical really quickly, but suffice it to say that HTTPS is an encrypted, safer way of sending data than HTTP. This makes your site more secure, and the SSL certificates required for this are often included in your hosting plan. Some hosting parties will even set it up automatically for you, so it's probably wise to pick one that does. And if you don't, just make sure you put in the effort to configure it when setting up your sites. How exactly you do this, again, depends on your hosting company. They should have the proper tutorials to help you. If not, you'll be able to contact them for support. Lastly, I'd like to note that once you've completed the installation, Your site is always available to you in your browser by navigating to your domain name /wp-admin. So, for example, everydayimtraveling.com/wp-admin. You can log in with your username and your password. Okay, now you know how things work in theory. Now, let's explore how you get from selecting a host to a working WordPress installation in practice in the upcoming screencasts.